Hey everybody, I am going to do a hammer smash and kind of in this style where it's sort of all together at an angle. Oh my gosh, there we go. Now you can see it. There's a mosaic I made a long time ago. So that is a 20 by 20 canvas. This is 10 by 10, so big difference. So hopefully I can get the same feel on a tiny canvas. Well, it's actually, there you go. This is actually a wood panel. I've been zooming in closer lately, and I'm hoping that I haven't been losing part of the video, part of the painting. Because, as most of you know, if you've watched my videos, I don't watch them myself. I film them and immediately upload them. I have no desire to review them. So, that's why pretty much what you see is what you get. There is nothing edited because I don't even watch them. I don't like them. I sound weird. And when I'm quiet, even I fast forward. Because some of my videos, when I am tilting the same spot for like 10 minutes, but I like showing it in real time. I like doing everything as close to reality as possible. You see enough fake stuff on in the media. So this is why am I blanking? Birch wood from But if you search, I did a while ago, I did a video comparing wood panels. I think I did Blick, Amazon, and might be Jerry's Artorama. And it turns out in almost all cases, Amazon was the cheapest. And I've used wood from all three, and they all seem to be of similar quality. I haven't noticed any differences. I'm sure there are some. Oh gosh, but I have never noticed any, and I've had a lot of experience with them, so. So this orange, I attempted to mix in this glitterific, which is just kind of pure crap. But I thought maybe if I just did a little bit in here, but you can't see it anyway, so. And then I've got Soho Magenta, which is a beautiful. This is Soho paint. It is from Jerry's, I like this magenta, but as far as like paint goes, I haven't noticed any difference between that and Liquitex or Artist Loft. Artist Loft is definitely, if you have a Michaels, Artist Loft is definitely the most cost effective because when they have sales, you're getting, I think they're 4.5, how much? 4.06 ounces, anywhere from 2 to 250, $2 to $2.50. So, Those are definitely the most cost efficient. The only negative with theirs is sometimes the paint is chunky when you're stirring it, when you're mixing it, but let it sit a day and it smooths out. Okay, there is no silicone in here. And let's torch it. Sorry, there's so many air bubbles. Very pretty, but I'm afraid to tilt it. I should tilt it up first. Because if I can tilt it up, it'll go off the wood. It might not be enough to tilt. It's not really moving. More forceful. Hopefully I don't ruin the entire thing by tilting it. But I would like it to go off the edges so then I can tilt it back down and open it up to webbing. Goal, anywho. First side down. Come on. See if I'm getting the webbing that I want. Or if it all just blends into mud. There is a chance either one of those things could happen. Thank you. to do is put more. And then I do have silicone in this white left over from the last pour. I'm going to use the airbrush. One ugly, ugly, ugly piece of art. Oh my goodness. That is just a big no. White left in here. I'm not adding the blue. I don't want any green or the orange and blue making gunk. see what happens with these cells. Glad I added the blue. It gave it like a needed oomph. Blue was definitely needed. So there you have it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you next time. Bye.